So I'm Steve Pergam. I'm the Director of Infection Prevention at the SCCA. And I'm lucky enough to work at the SCCA for probably the last 15 years. And it's first of all, a wonderful place to take care of patients, but it's also a privilege to be able to do things to help prevent people from getting infections. The National Cancer Institute defines immunocompromised as patients having certain diseases or conditions that weaken the immune system. Diseases like HIV or AIDS, cancer, amongst others, will prevent patients from developing appropriate responses to infection and increase the risk for those infections becoming more severe. Some terms that are used for this condition is immunocompromised, immune suppressed, weakened immune systems, or even a compromised host. And they're all the same and have similar pathways to leading to infection. Another term you may hear as a cancer patient is a condition called neutropenia. And neutropenia is when your cells, particularly a type of cell called neutrophils, are low. When neutrophils are low, it increases your risk of bacterial and fungal infections in particular. And typical people who develop neutropenia are patients who are undergoing treatment for leukemia or those undergoing a bone marrow transplant. And physicians often give those patients, because of that risk, some antibiotics to help prevent those complications from happening. So what can you do to help protect yourself? It's not just the doctor's responsibility, but you can take an active role in trying to prevent infections. So an easy step is to wash your hands. So we encourage you to wash your hands after going to the bathroom, before eating meals, and throughout the day. And what I mean throughout the day is when you're in the clinic, seeing your provider, or going to get your blood drawn, think about different times when you see those stations where you can use the alcohol sanitizer. Use that frequently. After you touch an elevator button or walked up the stairs and used the handrail, places where these germs can attach. And I encourage you to have alcoholic hand sanitizer in your pocket so that when you're in the public spaces, on the bus or going to the mall, make sure that you're using it on a frequent basis. Speaking of the mall and getting on the bus, I really do encourage patients who are immune compromised to try to avoid crowded places if possible. That's not always easy to do, but if you can go during points in the day when it's not as crowded, that can be helpful. And if you know a place is going to be very busy, it's an ideal to try to avoid places like that if possible. You need to live your life. You still need to go to the grocery store to get the things you need, but if you can go when it's not as crowded, it can be helpful in helping to prevent infection. And having hand sanitizer to use after you've been in those places can also help protect you. Another important step for you is to talk to your friends and family. It's important to make sure that they're up to date on their vaccinations, like flu vaccine, to help protect you. Additionally, when you have friends and family that are sick or feeling symptomatic, they have a fever or cold or cough, make sure they don't come to visit you during that time frame, because minor symptoms for them can lead to really severe infections for you. Another important step is to take the medications that are recommended to you by your physician. Some of those medications are appropriate for treating your cancer and your symptoms related to your cancer, but some of them may also be antibiotics that can help prevent you from getting infections. It's also important to discuss and review with your provider what vaccinations you need to help protect you during this process. So, important signs or symptoms: fever, chills, or sweats, change in cough or a new cough, shortness of breath, sore throat or new cold symptoms, nasal congestion, stiff neck or headache, burning or pain with urination, unusual vaginal discharge or irritation, redness, soreness, or swelling in any area, including surgical wounds and ports, diarrhea. There are others that if you notice that are not normal or somewhat uncomfortable for you, pain in places that you're not expecting, it's important to talk to your team and make sure it's not an infection. When you think about fever, Some teams may ask you to take your temperature multiple times during the day as part of a routine process for monitoring for infection. But if you have symptoms, warmth, you feel chills, or you think you might have a fever, take your temperature and call your care team to review those results. As a patient, it's important to have a thermometer at home. If you have a temperature greater than 101 or 101 Fahrenheit or 38.3 Celsius, you need to call your care team because that can indicate you might have a serious infection and they need to evaluate you. Additionally, if during an hour you take your temperature multiple times and it's over 100.3 or 100.4 or 38 Celsius or greater, you need to talk to your team because that can also be an indication. Thank you.